This is an academic technology tutorial on how to share a Google Doc and use it in a Zoom class. Begin by going to AU Direct and go to Google Drive or Google Docs, any way you usually get there. You can go to your Drive and then simply click the Docs. And you can do a new Google Doc. You can use a shared document for any purpose. If you're using it for meetings, you can share your agenda and multiple people can add items to it before your meeting and take notes on it during your meeting. If you're using it in a classroom, you might use it for brainstorming group projects, taking notes in a breakout room so that you can report back to the larger group, or something like that. I simply give my document a title, and I usually pick the title style or the heading one style for the biggest heading on my page. And you can start it with some text if you want, or you can start it blank. If you're using it with multiple groups, you might start with headings like Notes, Breakout Room 1, Notes, Breakout Room 2, or you might just start with a list of questions. And this can be a prompt for students to put their questions in to the Google Doc ahead of class, during class, whenever, and then you can address them throughout the lecture. Now, once you've started your document, it might only have a heading. To share it with your class, there are a couple of ways you can do it. In the Share tool, it's going to ask you to name your document, and it will take the title that you've put as the first text of the page to name it, or you can name it whatever you want. So let's just say ED1234. It's good to be specific if you have a lot of these documents floating around in your drive. They're easier to find if you give them a date and a really specific title. So you might make it really specific. Now, when you save it, it brings you to the share button, or you can click it up here. And there's two types of sharing. You can share with individuals, and you could just simply copy and paste the emails of all of your students in here. Make sure that they have the edit permission, which is the pencil. Or if you don't know who's going to be in your meeting, you can use the advanced tool, and you can change it from private access with individuals added to one of these options. Typically, I choose anyone at antioch.edu with the link. That means if anyone, faculty, staff, or student is logged into their antioch.edu account and clicks on the link to this document, they will automatically have access. If you put it on antioch.edu and it doesn't say with the link, that means that they can search for it in their Google search, in their Google Docs search, and anyone could find it. And if your students are, say, continuing ed students that don't have an Antioch account, you could use anyone with the link. It's up to you about how sensitive the content in the document will be. If it's not sensitive and just useful, these two would be perfectly fine. If it is sensitive, I recommend that you use the shared with named people only. So remember, after you pick one of these links, you can also have anyone at Antioch with EDU with the link can view it or can edit it. So that's one way to go. And this is the more open way. Or if you go back here, you can just simply put in the names of your students or meeting group or whoever. You can choose to add a message. In this case, I'll just say, hey guys, this is just a test. Ignore it. But you could give them content. You could say something like, we are going to use this in class this week. Make sure you have the link available in your email. Okay. And then when you hit send, you can also send a copy to yourself if you like. So for these guys, I'm just going to cancel this, but you would hit send. So once you have your Google document, you can simply log into Zoom, like I have here, and you can share your screen if you want them to see it on your screen. So this is the screen with the document on it. You can share that screen and the document will be up there. And people could log in on other devices with their phones and make edits. Or if they have two monitors, they can have the Google Doc pulled up in a web browser on their second monitor, and they can be editing the document, and you will see the edits as it goes. All right, so you would hit share, and I'm just going to cancel for right now because I'm already sharing. And when you look at this document, what you'll see is several people with little faces up here, the little Google icons. When each student is active or logged in, their little icon like this will be on there. And each person will come in and edit. And when they click in here, Google will give their cursor a colored link, and they can, their cursor will be a certain color and always that color. And then you can have them put your name. So this could say, can you tell me more about Waldorf? And you can say, our class is going to say, just put your name next to your question so I know who asked. Or you can say, when we use our notes for the breakout rooms, please put the list of attendees in that breakout room and then put your notes down below. And you can set them up this up for them in advance if you want it to be really structured, or you can just leave it blank if you don't mind it them structuring their notes however they like. At the end of the session, these notes will all be available for everyone to see. They can make a copy of them themselves from up here or download the document in a format that they can use, and they can use them. So you could make separate Google Docs for Breakout Room 1, Breakout Room 2, or the students could even make their own Google Doc if that's how they decide they want to take notes instead of using the whiteboard. I hope this was a helpful tip. If you have any questions, please email us at at antioch.edu.